How are we doing, guys? This is Dr. Ruben Valdez together with
Dr. Ryan Valenza. Good morning.
Of Novis Health. And this month, May, is actually Clean Air Awareness Month. And we thought it'd be a really special topic for us to be able to tackle for you today, primarily because a lot of people don't know how profoundly linked air pollution and indoor air quality is to chronic health issues like low thyroid, autoimmune diseases, cognitive function. So we wanted to make this information very, very actionable, very understandable, and really bring it in a way that will allow you to start asking questions about the potential relationship between your own health issues and the air quality around you. So the first thing we're going to hit is what is, you know, clean air, and what are some of the benefits of it?
Yes, six major benefits of clean air. One of the big ones is helping with digestive health. And just in practice, digestive health is something we see issues with all the time. People with chronic constipation, irritable bowel syndrome, IBD. It's so common nowadays, and people always want that simple solution to it, but oftentimes the root cause is never actually addressed. It's actually been scientifically shown to improve blood pressure as well as heart function and cardiovascular output. Makes you happier. We could all use a little more happiness in our life, right?
Oh, yeah.
I felt that way when my four kids were keeping me up all night last night. It also strengthens the immune system, which is important with chronic health conditions. As people are chronically ill, it puts a burden on their immune system. And if you're not supporting that on the backside, stress, air quality, those things play a large role. It cleans your lungs. Oxygen balance helps the flow of oxygen and carbon dioxide. And when you become oxygen deficient, the air health or the health of the lung tissue itself will be affected. And it gives you better energy and a sharper mind. So those would be some of the larger issues we're dealing with air quality.
Yeah, that's huge. And as you can imagine, our world is changing so rapidly outside, you know, and like Dr. Valencik was saying, there's so much research linking increased level of happiness, detoxification with being outside. However, the outside environment is changing rapidly, but even more so, the indoor quality of the air that we breathe every single day is just declining. From the toxins that we put into our homes, from the products that we use to clean, the paint, the carpeting, something called volatile organic compounds are very, very prevalent in homes. Each day, homes are ventilated less and less from the outside in, and they're more ventilated through HVAC systems, which allow these toxins to continue to circulate within the home. But one threat above all else is really becoming more and more prevalent, and that is mold-related illness. So mold is so prevalent, even in places like Denver, where it's actually a very dry climate, even worse in the East and West Coast, where humidity levels and readings are through the roof. It only takes a very small amount of water to infiltrate and sit over a 48-hour window for mold to begin to grow in a home. Once there's mold, it gets sucked up, and the HVAC just takes those particles, known as biotoxins, all over the home. Now, this doesn't really affect everyone in the home in the same way, because like many things, there's a big genetic component. And about 22% of the population carries a gene called HLA-DRDQ, specific variants to that gene that can make them very susceptible to the toxins in their indoor environment. So if you have the susceptibility and the exposure, people start developing symptoms, and the symptoms can be really broad and complex. Dr. Valencik?
That's a long list. Anything from fatigue and weakness, headaches, memory loss, difficulty concentrating. You'll see it even in school-age children. We talk about the issues with ADD and attention issues, and a lot of it starts with air quality and pollutants in the body. Disorientation, confusion, vertigo is another one. You'll see extreme thirst. Some people, especially in drier climates, will deal with nosebleeds, itchy eyes, sore throat. So common things you're going to see with even seasonal allergies, wheezing, people with chronic sinusitis, muscle aches, stomach issues, and shock issues.
Yeah, and interestingly, it is so immunoactivating that people with already pre-existing autoimmune conditions, we know they can be extremely flared up by their indoor environment, And in addition to that, even people without a pre-existing autoimmune disease, we've seen people being exposed for the first time and now developing an autoimmunity. This is an autoimmune trigger that's rarely ever checked for by most doctors that deal with autoimmunity, and you'd be surprised how central and how key it is to actually helping the immune system move into a state of remission is addressing these things. So there's a few tests that can happen medically to figure out if this is actually a problem for you. Also a few in-home tests, and maybe in a minute Dr. Valencia can address that piece of it as far as the in-home testing. As far as medical testing, it's really easy now and cheap to perform a genetic test. It runs for, I don't know, less than $100 to get your genes looked at and determine if you are a carrier of this variant of the HLA-DRDQ that makes you either multi-susceptible, mold susceptible, or susceptible to an infection called Marcon's. If you were to test susceptible, the next step is now figuring out if with these genetics you have had an exposure that's creating this chronic inflammatory immune response. If that's the case, then we can go and first look at the home and figure out how that can be best handled.
Yeah, there are two tests. There's the ERMI test and the Hertzsprung test. Both of them are highly accurate. And the issue we've run into, we've had patients that we suspected biotoxin illness and mold issues with. And we had, quote, mold specialists come in and evaluate and analyze the home and with the assessment come back saying everything's normal.
Yep.
Yet the issue is the smaller particles are not picked up by the eye or by the cheaper in-home testing that's done. So we do use a Swiffer test where you're going through certain different areas of the home, you're Swiffering up, it picks up even the smallest particles, and then they culture it and they're able to determine, are you dealing with black mold issues that may be missed by the common eye?
Right.
We had a specific case of a patient, the husband was dealing with severe cognitive decline early onset. He was in his mid-50s.
Yeah.
And they had multiple people come to the house say, nope, everything's clear, you don't have a mold issue. And all of a sudden we were sitting there one day and we had a report, a follow-up report based on the testing that we had them run.
Yep.
And I mean, it was awful. When they started pulling away baseboards, I mean, it was, I mean, layers and layers of really dangerous black mold that was being ventilated and circulated throughout their home.
Yeah. And the crazy thing is, unless somebody would have taken the time to be that rigorous and that diligent and understand how to properly test this home, two experts had already told them the house wasn't a problem. And when they peeled back that wall, they were just blown away. A lot of other clinical tests can correlate to these findings, things like NeuroQuant, which is a specialized MRI that looks for atrophy in certain regions of the brain in people that have had this type of exposure and are experiencing cognitive symptoms. However, I mean, that we can go real deep into that. We won't on this video. We just wanted to create a little bit more awareness on May about the value and the importance of clean air. A few fundamental basic things, like Dr. Valencik said, envirobiomics.com, you can get some really affordable, great quality in-home testing to figure out your air quality within your home. Things as basic as a HEPA filter, an air oasis can be of a lot of benefit. Vacuuming frequently, only a few chemicals actually will get rid of mold spores in the home. Things like Fantastic and Formula 409, which can break down aromatic rings. So those are just a few tools. We have a lot more content on this. So if you're interested in learning more, please comment below, subscribe to the channel. We're going to be putting great information out like this all the time. And there's even a little bell, an alert bell next to the subscribe button. Every time we post a new video, if you click on that bell, you'll get an alert that there's a new video for you to watch. So thank you for spending these minutes with us, and have yourself a fantastic rest of your day.
We'll talk to you soon.